Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing conformal mapping type number 2, that is bilinear transformation B, mapping through bilinear transformation, and this is our fifth example. So friends, till now we are done with four examples. In the first three examples, we map line through bilinear transformation. In the fourth example, we saw how to map circle through bilinear transformation. Here also we are going to see how to map a circle through a bilinear transformation. So this is our given problem. This bilinear transformation is clearly given to us. In the last problem, we need to find it out this BLT. Points were given. But here the problem is simple because bilinear transformation is already provided to us. So what is the first step? The problem is W equal to, and we need to convert it into Z equal to. So let us start. W equal to phi minus 4Z upon 4Z minus 2. First step is cross multiply, and we should get Z equal to 4WZ minus 2W equal to phi minus 4Z. What next? All Z this side, W that side. 4WZ plus 4Z equal to phi plus 2W. So if you take Z common here, you will get 4W plus 4, which is equal to phi plus 2W. So basically Z is phi plus 2W upon 4W plus 4. So this is the value of Z. Here we need to map a circle, that is mod Z is equal to 1. So problem is very simple, just put here. This will be phi plus 2W upon 4W plus 4 equal to 1. What next? Cross multiply. So this goes this side. This is phi plus 2W equal to 4W plus 4. We have discussed number of times. Whenever we get W, we need to replace with U plus IV. Here also W will be replaced by U plus IV. Let's separate real and imaginary. Phi plus 2U is real part plus I2V is imaginary part. And here 4u plus 4 is real plus i4v is imaginary. Mod of a complex number is square root of real square plus imaginary square. Phi plus 2u the whole square plus, we don't consider I and plus, so 2v square. Square root of this square, so 4u plus 4 the whole square plus 4v the whole square. Let's take square on both the sides. So if you take square, these two square roots will be cancelled, and you will get 5 plus 2u the whole square plus 2v the whole square is equal to 4u plus 4 the whole square plus 4v the whole square. Let's open the bracket. 5 plus 2u the whole square plus 2v the whole square. A plus b the whole square. A square plus 2ab. So that is 20u plus b square. That is 4u square plus 4v square is equal to. Right hand side, same formula, a plus b the whole square. A square plus twice ab, 32u plus 16v square. Let us simplify this. So in short, we getting 12u square, 4u square. If this 16u square comes this side, that will become minus 16u square. So minus 16u square plus 4u square is minus 12u square. Let's see how many v square we do have. 16v square, 4v square, 16v square this side, minus 16v square plus 4v square.
that is minus 12 v square. Here we do have 20 u, and here we do have 32 u. So we'll be left with minus 12 u. 25, 16, minus 16 this side, so that will be plus 9 equal to 0. So this is the equation we got. But friends, remember, is it a equation of circle? Yes or no? Yes, it could be, but how? Always remember, in case of equation of circle, whether it is standard or non-standard, with x square and y square, we always have 1. X square plus y square is equal to a square. So with x square and y square, we do have 1. So here, we need to divide it by this minus 12. Because we do want with u square and v square 1. So if you divide by minus 12, u square plus v square plus u minus 12. So that will become minus 3 by 4 equal to 0. Now this is circle. We need to get center and radius. So for that purpose, we need to equate it with x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. So if you compare 2g equal to, with x we do have 2g, with u we have 1. So g is equal to half. 2f, with y we do have 2f, with y or with v here we don't have anything, that is 0. So f equal to 0. Last is constant term, that is c. Here c is minus 3 by 4. So what is the center? Minus g comma minus f. So center is minus g. So minus of this, that is minus half comma 0. And what is the radius? Root of g square plus f square minus c. So root of g square, f square 0 minus c, and c is minus 3 by 4. So minus c means that will become plus 3 by 4, which will be, this is 1 by 4 plus 3 by 4, going to get root of 1, that is 1. Center is minus half comma 0 and radius is 1. So in z plane, it was mod z is equal to 1, that is circle with radius 1, and here it is converted into w plane with the center as minus half comma 0. So this will be minus half comma 0 and the radius is 1. So circle will be something like this. This is minus half comma 0 and its radius is 1. So this is the radius 1. This is your w plane image. So we're done with the problem. Now friends, few students might be thinking, in every problem there is some difference. Procedure is different. Slight changes are there. So if you want to leave some topic, I don't advise you to leave something, but if you don't have time, at least you should be done with type number 2A, that is cross ratio property problems. That means W minus W1, W2, W minus W3, and that problem with fixed points. At least you should do this. If you have time, you should cover the entire topic. Thank you.